Welcome to
Fully Cooked,
because we cook like a bunch of fools too.
Fully
Cooked!
Today I'm going to show you how to clean and care for your cast iron and tell you what not to do. These are my nasty pots behind me. I'm going to show you how I clean them and re-season them.
Oh, of course.
Wow. Here's my nasty skillets. You can tell I cook every single meal at home from scratch. All right, let's get started. You see this pan here? This is an example of what not to do. I had cooked some fried taters in here and I did not put enough oil. Cast iron pans, you must use oil. That's how they work. The best oil to use is bacon grease, honestly. The next best for your health is coconut oil. But anyway, you need to use an ample amount of oil when you cook with a cast iron skillet. Also, the second thing you don't want to do is cook ground beef. And this is what is stuck to my pan. I mean, do as I say, not as I do, because I cook ground beef, I cook everything in my cast iron pans. That's why they look like this. The second example of what not to do, you need to use a good amount of butter when you cook eggs or some type of fat, or else pans are gonna stick. This is tomato paste that is stuck on there. Tomatoes are very acidic. You never wanna put sauces and things in your cast iron pans. It will take the seasoning off of your pan. Don't do that either.
But you're gonna keep doing this over and over again till the end of days. So why you say not to do it?
If you wanna keep a good seasoning on your pan, don't do what I do. I do this and most of the time I don't wash my pans and I just keep reusing it. And they say basically the food in cast iron skillets tastes like food that your grandmother used to cook. It's because it is. Because when you cook something in a cast iron skillet, it will go into the skillet and it flavors all of the food that you ever make. So to keep a good seasoning on it, to keep the good flavors, you don't want to cook these foods in your cast iron skillet. When you have a good season on your egg pan, you're set. Also, cast iron pans will raise your iron levels if you cook out of them frequently. If you have low iron, you cook in cast iron pans, it'll raise your iron levels. This could be a bad thing if you have too much iron, you'll need to lower it by giving blood once in a while. I have too much iron, it makes me feel better to give blood. Same with my grandpa, he ate out of cast iron skillets his whole life. His iron was way high, my dad's iron's way high, my son's iron's way high, they need to give blood. So. The two tools that I use for cleaning my pans, this is a scraper that I got at Walmart for 97 cents. It scrapes, it's really good. And also I've had this for a couple of years. It's just one of those dollar store scrub brushes. I need to get another one, but yeah, it works just fine. So these are the two tools that I use. This is a nylon bristle tool. Alright, just while it's dry, I'm going to take this scrubber and I'm just going to scrape all of this out. Just dump this out in the garbage. Turn on your hot water. You can let it sit for a little bit. You don't want to let a cast iron pan sit with water in it though, because it does start rusting. Don't drop it. I feel you. Remember to get the outside of your pan as well. You don't so much have to get the bottom, but you do have to get the sides really well. And you can see that this is already seasoned. The water is just pooling up on here. All right, as soon as you take it off of the water, it will start rusting. It is starting to rust right now. All right, let's put it on the stove. We're gonna cook the water off. Go ahead and turn it on high. All right, now you're gonna take the oil that you want to season with. Now, mind you, we can't get rendered bacon grease here because they don't sell bacon here. Pour it on a rag or preferably some paper towels, but we don't have any, so we don't use disposable things here. You're gonna take this, wipe the inside of your cast iron down with it really well. This is a very old pan. So it has many layers of seasoning on it, as you can see. But also layers where there's no seasoning. And then you can take it on the outside as well. And because I don't wash this with soap, it always comes out black. You can't make a white sauce in a cast iron skillet. Put it back on the heat, add a little more oil, and you're gonna wipe most of this out with a rag. I'm gonna get it hot first though, and slide it around on the skillet. I still have this on max heat. It's starting to smoke a little bit, so that's when you wanna take it off and rub the oil in. Just rub it in really good. What I like to do now is turn the stove off and put this back on there and just leave it on there until it cools off. And that's how I season my skillets. Now I want to show you, this is my egg pan. It's my favorite pan. The quickest and easiest way to season a pan is to put a lot of butter in it and cook pancakes or eggs in a lot of butter. And the best way is to cook pancakes because you keep adding butter and then you add a pancake and then you add butter and you add a pancake and it adds layers and layers and layers of seasoning and it gets really seasoned quickly. For your first batch of pancakes, it'll be seasoned. Now you can see here that this water is not staying on this pan at all because it is very, very seasoned. The thing is, you do have to use quite a bit of oil so your eggs won't stick or so your food won't stick, so you don't even have to wash it. And that's a mistake that I make every time when I cook eggs. I don't put enough butter in there. I just want to warn you, when you're seasoning your pan on the stove and it starts to smoke, you definitely need a lot of ventilation. You don't want to be breathing that. And it can smoke pretty rapidly, so don't walk away from it. Just stay with it. It only takes a few minutes. Okay.
They're clean. Again.
And that's how I season my skillets. Now what I like to do is turn the skillet off.
You stay normal. You stay normal. Normal how you were earlier. Ready? What are you saying?
Fully
cooked!
Hi guys, thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, could you give it a thumbs up? Also, we would love it if you subscribed. We have two other channels, I Need More Lives, which is a weight loss and health channel, and Fully Living, that is our family daily vlog channel. And we make a video every single day. Leave a comment down below and let me know you are here. Thanks a lot. Have a great day. So, this is a little awkward. Have you decided to subscribe yet? You can watch last week's video. You can click the link right here. Hello? It's 4:36 a.m. right now. I really care about you. And I hope you have a great day. But if you're mean, bye, Felicia. Me love you long time.